أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إن الحمد لله تبارك وتعالى نحمده ونستعين به ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كلام الله تعالى وخير الهدي هدي سيدنا محمد عليه الصلاة والسلام وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار وما قل ودل خير مما كثر ألها وقليل يغنيك خير من كثير يطغيك وإنما توعدون لآت وما أنتم بمعجزين وبعد Dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, JazakAllah khair, brothers, for bringing the table and the chair. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you and reward you for that. Allahumma amin ya rabbal alameen. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept from us and to add these moments in our skill of hasanat. Allahumma amin ya rabbal alameen. So today, inshallah, I would like to start my halaqa with a hadith from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and a story from the life of the sahaba of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and they seem contradicting. But when we explain, you will realize that they are not contradicting, because the Sahaba of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam are the people who applied the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and they're the people who understand the Sunnah of Rasulullah more than anybody else, radiallahu anhu. And then the second point, I would like to mention three conditions of obeying or disobeying the people who are in authority, because last Friday we were talking to the people who are in authority. We were giving them a message from the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Whether they are like he is a president in a country, he is a ruler, he is a president in an organization, he is an imam, he is a leader, he is just a boss at work, whatever else. And we will also mention why we're talking about this topic today, the topic of the people are in authority and the people are under authority. Why we're talking about this? We are talking about this actually to reflect a little bit on what's happening in our Muslim countries back home. And we see how a lot of people rebel against the authorities, and they fight against the police and the military, and the people are in authority, hoping that they will change al-munkar and to replace the evil with what's good. And they end up harming themselves and harming others and destroying their countries. And subhanallah, like you saw what happened in Egypt 2 weeks ago. Some people killed 235 people because they are just Sufi. Huh? 300 were killed? Wallahi, I heard 235. They increased? Alhamdulillah. طيب إن الله وإن إليه راجعون. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to shower His mercy on them. Allahumma amin ya rabbil alameen. You know why this happening? This is happening because there is no knowledge, and these extreme ideas exist everywhere. They exist everywhere. But you know why people here live side by side and they don't fight? Because we are in a strong country, and we have law over here. Like here in this country, we have Shia and Sunnah. They live together side by side. You know, a month ago or something, a brother came to me and he was looking for a sister to marry. And then he sent you, I said, okay, just please email me. Send him an email, and I give him my card. And then he wrote the details. And then at the end of his email, he signed Shia Ali. His signature was Shia Ali. وَأَنَا أَعْرَفْ هَذَا الْأَخْ يَعْنِي يَمْكِنْ مِنْ سَنَتِينَ. I know him since 2 years. And I used to meet him almost every day in Tim Hortons in the morning before I go to work. And then, subhanAllah, I said to him, what do you mean Shia, Ali? Are you Shi'i? He said, yeah, I am Shi'i. And I didn't know anything about that. Why? Because we live together here because we're in Canada. But if this brother exists somehow in Egypt, they will fight with him, for example. And in some other Muslim countries. You know why? Because we don't respect the laws. We don't respect the authorities in our countries. But here we do. Subhanallah. Not everybody is like this, but that's one of the reasons. It's not the only reason why we live here in peace from different countries and different groups and different cultures. It's not the only reason because Canada is a strong country and we have laws. No, it's one of the reasons, the many reasons that we have. And also the other reason is that we intend to change the munkar, but we end up actually causing some munkar and some evil. And then we destroy our countries. And that happened in Syria and in Libya and in Tunis and in some other places in the Islamic world. And it's happening nowadays in Egypt. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect all of our Muslim countries. Allahumma ameen. So these ideas exist everywhere. So this halaqa inshaAllah ta'ala is a message to the people who are under authority. Last Friday was to the people who are in authority to be just. And today it's to the general public, inshallah. And everything is from the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And I'm not going to go to one of the extremes. I'm not going to say just listen and obey, no matter what they say or what they do. I'm not going to say that because it's not the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And I'm not going to say just try to change and fight with them whenever they do something evil. It's not what I'm going to say. We will try, inshallah, to seek a middle path from the sunnah of Rasulullah and the sunnah of the sahaba of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, because that's what he said, alaykum bi sunnati and also wa sunnat al khulafa al rashidin al mahdiyin min ba'di, and also the four guided khalifas after me sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So we need to also learn from the sahaba. I will start with this hadith and then tell you the story that seemed to contradict this hadith. The hadith is reported by Imam Muslim. سلمة ابن يزيد الجعفي سأل رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. سلمة ابن يزيد الجعفي said, يا رسول الله أرأيت إن قامت علينا أمراء يسألون حقهم ويمنعون حقنا فما تأمرنا. Very direct question from a Sahabi to the teacher صلى الله عليه وسلم. يا رسول الله, imagine if it's the case that we have rulers, we have presidents, we have khalifas who are not just towards us. And they don't give us our rights. But they still ask us for their rights. We pay a lot of tax. We pay a lot of money for electricity, power bills, and phone bills. Of course, they didn't have bills, radiallahu anhum, but still, they didn't have phone bills or power bills, but we do. But those leaders, they ask for their rights. They ask for obedience, to listen and obey. But they don't give us our rights on them. فَمَا تَأْمُرُنَا. Well, what should we do? Your advice, Ya Rasulullah. فَقَالَ النَّبِيُّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ Nabi Salam أعرض عنه. The first time Nabi Salam didn't respond to him. Because this Sahabi رضي الله عنه is asking for a permission for what? To go change what's evil. And the Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam is not 100% sure that he can change what's evil in the proper way. Maybe he will cause something evil like what's happening in the Muslim world nowadays. Since he turned his back towards him alayhi salatu wasalam, he didn't give him an answer. Then the Sahabi sa'alahu the same question again. He asked the same question. فَقَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ. They don't give us our rights, they ask for their rights. قَالْ إِسْمَعُوا وَأَطِيعُوا. Listen to them and obey. فَإِنَّ عَلَيْهِمْ مَا حُمِّلُوا وَعَلَيْكُمْ مَا حُمِّلْتُمْ. They are responsible for their obligations and you are also responsible and accountable for yours. Just do what you have to do and if Qiyamah Allah will ask both of you, will question both of you subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the hadith. And from this hadith we understand that we have to listen and obey to people on authority without asking. But if you see the Sahaba of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, how they applied this hadith, you would understand something else. Sayyidina Umar radiallahu anhu, استلم بعض الغنائم جاءت إلى المدينة. كان على المدينة radiallahu anhu, and he has received, Sayyidina Umar radiallahu anhu, he has received them, some of the spoils of war, some of the battles. The Sahaba had some ghanaim, and they sent it to Umar radiallahu anhu to distribute it among the Muslimin. And these spoils of war that we have were some pieces of cloth. And they were only for males, not for females. So Sayyidina Umar radiallahu anhu decided to distribute all these pieces of cloth among the men in Al-Madina equally. And he was just, radiallahu anhu. He was very famous of his justs. He learned from Rasulullah alayhi salatu wasalam. Sayyidina Umar did that. And next Friday, everybody now has his piece of cloth. He needs to, like, some of them will keep it at home, some of them will have some new clothes, new thawb. Sayyidina Umar radiallahu anhu, next Friday, next khutbah, he was given khutbah and wearing a new thawb from the same kind of cloth that he distributed among the sahab. But Sayyidina Umar radiallahu anhu was very tall. كان الصحابة إذا رأوه ماشيا خلف سور مثلا يظنوه راكبا فرسا. If the Sahaba would see Umar radiallahu anhu walking behind a wall or behind a fence, they would think Umar is riding a horse because he was too tall. And when he rides a horse, his feet would touch the ground radiallahu anhu. لذلك كان إذا اجتمع الصحابة برز عمر وخالد. Whenever the Sahaba gather together and they're walking together, Umar and Khalid radiallahu anhum are the tallest, very tall. So Sayyidina Umar radiallahu anhu was in the member and he's very tall and having a new cloth. And then after المقدمة, the introduction, أما بعد أيها الناس اسمعوا وأطيعوا. O people, listen and obey, radiallahu anhu Umar. The Sahaba radiallahu anhum, he saw the cloth. Then one of them stood up, Salman al-Farisi. And look at his respect towards Sayyidina Umar. قال يا أمير المؤمنين. ما قالوش يا عمر. He didn't say يا عمر. He said يا أمير المؤمنين. أنزلوا الناس ما نزله. سيدنا سلمان الفارسي رضي الله عنه still respects عمر رضي الله عنه. And that's why جماعة بنقول لما تقول اسم صحابي تقول سيدنا وبعدها رضي الله عنه. When you say one of the Sahaba's name, try to say سيدنا before and رضي الله عنه after. Okay. So he said, يا أمير المؤمنين لا سمع ولا طاعة. We will not listen and obey to you. Umar said, why? He said, because look at yourself. You're wearing a new cloth and you're taller than us. It's obvious that you have taken two pieces of cloth and you have given everybody only one piece. Look to that level they used to investigate and ask the ruler and the Khalifa about everything. And you know what? He used to listen. Radiallahu anhu. He's okay. One time he was giving a khutbah and a woman stood up and opposed Umar. She contradicted him. She said something against what he's saying. قال أخطأ عمر وأصابت امرأة. You're right, I'm wrong. Radiallahu an Umar. Radiallahu an Sayyidina Umar. Radiallahu an. طيب. Then Sayyidina Umar radiallahu anhu looked at his son Abdullah. قم يا عبد الله. Abdullah ibn Umar أسلم قبل أبي. Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Umar, he became a Muslim before his father Umar radiallahu anhu. So Umar said, stand up, يا Abdullah. Get up and tell them. Abdullah said, إن أبي رجل طويل. You know that my father is a tall man. He's taller than us. وإنه قد أخذ ثوب وإنه قد أخذ ثوبي. فصنع منهما ثوبا له. And he took my piece of cloth and he has made this tall thawb for himself. رضي الله عنه. So he didn't take anything more. فقال سلمان الآن نسمح ونطيع. سلمان said, yeah, just right now. Here we listen and obey to you, Umar. Now we trust you more. We know that you're just towards us. You're applying the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So the first hadith, when Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, listen and obey, no matter what your rulers do, it doesn't mean that Islam asks us to accept and to be okay with people who oppress others. Islam doesn't ask us to just, don't ask for our rights, and it's okay for the poor to be oppressed and everybody to wrong them. No. Islam doesn't ask for this. But at the same time, Islam doesn't ask us to go and destroy our countries and fight with one another. So what's the difference now between what Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said and what Sayyidina Salman and Sayyidina Umar did? Radiallahu anhuma. The difference is the situation. Sayyidina Salman knows that if he speaks to Umar, Umar would listen. And Umar would not put him in jail. He will not fight against him. He will not humiliate him in front of people. But nowadays, if you want to change something, and you have some president or some ruler or some leader, and you know that if you stand up and try to speak up, what's going to happen? Maybe a bigger fitna will happen. Bigger problem will happen. It's better for you just to let it go, because it's a smaller problem. Otherwise, you will make a bigger munkar. There is a munkar, but it's small. If you fight, you'll make it bigger. Your country, you're oppressed. You had to pay lots of tax, and you were having like financial crises. But now people are being killed. 300 people were killed while they're praying Jum'ah. Why? Because they think they want to change the munkar. And now they caused a bigger munkar. طيب يا جماعة. It's clear, right? Okay. That's the first idea that I wanted to mention. The second idea, I mentioned why we're talking about this. Two, I mentioned that two situations, and we know now they're not contradicting. These are two different situations. Third thing, inshallah, three conditions from the ahadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that we need to have to listen and obey to people on authority. Very quickly, inshallah ta'ala. The first condition, أَلَّا يُؤْمَرْ بِمَعْصِيَةٍ. As long as he's asking you to do something that pleases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you need to listen to him. If he asks you to displease Allah in any way, shape or form, you don't have to obey him. You don't have to. You will not be questioned about that. Al-Imam al-Bukhari al-Muslim narrated, and Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Umar radiallahu anhuma, قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم على المرء المسلم السمع والطاعة فيما أحب وكره. It's obligatory upon a Muslim to listen and obey to his rulers, to the people who are in authority, whether he likes it or dislikes it. It doesn't matter. Just listen and obey. And then he said, إِلَّا أَن يُؤْمَرَ بِمَعْصِيَةٍ. Except if you're asked to disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, فَإِذَا أَمَرَ بِمَعْصِيَةٍ أَوْ فَإِذَا أُمِرَ بِمَعْصِيَةٍ فَلَا سَمْعَ وَلَا طَاعَةٍ. When you're asked to disobey Allah, don't listen and obey. Second condition, لَا تَكْلِيفَ إِلَّا بِمَا يُطَاق. It has to do. It has to be something that you can do. You can do it. You're able to do it. Because you know what? Even if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala himself, the ultimate authority, asks us to do something which we can't, he will not ask us. He will not question us. Go for Hajj. Ya Rabbi, I can't. I don't have enough money. I can't. Physically, I can't. Khalas. You're not going to be questioned. Zakah, an obligation. But I don't have enough money. Khalas, no problem. Siyam, but I can't fast Ramadan. It's okay. So if we apply this with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he allowed us and he gave us permission, if we can't, to not obey because we can't, and it's actually in itself obedience, same thing is applicable or is implemented with the human beings, no matter who they are. Reported al-Bukhari al-Muslim عن سيدنا عبد الله بن عمر قال كنا إذا بايعنا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. When we give رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم البيعة, to obey him, to listen and obey على السمع والطاعة, يقول لنا فيما استطعتم. Between two practices, he used to say, as long as you can do it, as long as you're able to do it, عليه الصلاة والسلام. It has to be something that you can do. Last point, which is the last condition, إعطاء الحقوق لأهلها. To give everybody his due rights and then ask for your rights. And that's what we found in the story of Salman رضي الله عنه with Umar رضي الله عنه, that he did not listen and obey until he made sure that Umar رضي الله عنه didn't take another extra piece of cloth for himself. رضي الله عن الصحابة وصلى الله على المعلم والمربي رسول الله. وأقول قولي هذا وإني داع فأمنه. اللهم لك الحمد كما ينبغي لجلال وجهك ولعظيم سلطانك. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد في الأولين وصل عليه في الآخرين وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. اللهم اجعل هذا الجمع الكريم مرحوما. اللهم اجعل هذا الجمع الكريم مرحوما. اللهم اجعل هذا الجمع الكريم مرحوما وتفرقنا من بعده معصوما. ولا تجعل فينا ولا بيننا شقيا ولا محروما. اللهم علمنا ما جهلنا واغفر لنا وارحمنا وإلى غيرك لا تكلنا ومن شرور خلقك سلمنا آمين 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 وصل اللهم على نبينا مولانا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك السلام عليكم ورحمة الله